am Joe Moss. I'm one of the owners of the company. My three brothers and I own JTM today, and I take care of operations at JTM. The company was founded in the late 70s by my father, Jack Thomas Moss. We have three processing lines at JTM. We have a grind and form operation where we grind meat and form hamburger patties, but we also form meatballs and steak hoagies and pork sausage patties. So we grind and form a variety of products in our grind and form operation. We have a kettle cooking operation with two lines. Kettle cooking is anything you can cook and then pump through a 4-inch pipe. It has to be fluid enough such that it can be pumped to pouches is the primary packaging that we do or the way we sell the product. And so that would be like chili, taco filling, sloppy joe, spaghetti sauce with meat. The third thing we do at JTM is we have a bakery, and we make hoagie buns, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 12-inch long hoagie buns, primarily for pizzerias. Something a little bit less than 10% of our production goes to the military, and we are quite proud. We are sending product to Afghanistan and Iraq feeding our troops. About 65% of our business goes to school lunch cafeterias. Because we are selling to the school lunch program, they have some pretty strict dietary requirements. Requirements related to fat levels and calorie levels. And so we here at JTM have developed a process by which we can produce very low fat, very low calorie finished products that are very desirable by the schools throughout the country. And so that we can provide the most nutritious food for our young. After we cook the meat, we put it on a vibratory conveyor with small holes in it, and the water that we cook the meat in and the fat that we render in out of it, plus any small pieces of meat that'll fit through the very small holes, fines if you will, drop through the vibratory conveyor, and that water has to be treated or dealt with. And we use the Flottweg Tricanter to separate the fines, the fat, and the water.
We are in the process room for the Tricanter to separate grease, solids, and water. We need to reduce the amount of water that we send to the city, and we need to make that water quality as good as we can possibly get it. By dewatering, then we can remove the materials that are contaminating the water and either reuse them or recover them for some other purpose. The solid phase is placed in containers, and those containers are hauled off for potential animal feed use. The tallow is captured, and that is used as a chicken feed additive. And that's a revenue stream where the solids are not at this point. We had at one point used a centrifuge, but it was a vertical stack design with a number of plates inside. And we separated, and we got good quality grease from it, but we had too many solids, and the solids were too wet. So we stored those and had to have those hauled off at a relatively high cost. So we wanted to reduce our cost in that area by making a better separation. And we were trying to go for drier solids, more pure grease, and cleaner water.
We are very pleased to find companies like Flottweg that are willing to work with us to work through a sort of an unusual problem, to take on something that's not your normal everyday process, and to somehow or another work together and conquer it.
At Flottweg, everybody seems to be involved, and if I can't get a hold of one person, I know I can get a hold of someone else and they can help me just as well.